I had had the privilege of watching Jaya Bhadri in a film called Suman. And I was completely enchanted with her performance because it was unlike the other performances I'd seen. I really marveled at that and I said, my God, if by going to the Film Institute I can achieve that, that's what I want to do. So far, so good. Then it was the turn for my screen test. That I continue to marvel that in spite of such an awful screen test, why did they finally take me? And when I asked Taneja Saab that, he says, Nigaah hoti hai hamari.
I am from the first batch. Probably many people do not know. When we did not have a hostel, we used to sleep on the floor on the studio.
And every day there were movies to see. You could take your pick. I mean, there were like 3 movies a day. You could walk into anyone. It was like being in heaven.
They were the best years of my life, and I learned so much that was taught and so much that was not taught, but one observed or one saw and one learned on one's own.
The Film Institute had not started in 1961. There was no chance of my becoming a filmmaker.
There is a platform like Institute which has given us the guidance to how to approach perfection through a sense of abstraction.
The role that FTII has played in my life is the source. Source for everything that I wanted to do, source for everything I wanted to be.
You know, from the gate itself, it was, you know, it was entering into a new world.
It's almost a journey from innocence to experience.
And I am one such example who had no background or no inclination towards filmmaking or going to cinema halls, but I think I evolved very well as a technician and a filmmaker.
It gives a hope to anyone, you know, if I can get through, anybody can.
Today, what am I? Today, people know what David Dhawan is. I mean, the background is FTII.
I think FTII basically, I think, has given filmmaking a dignity.
ट्रेनिंग की मैं समझती हूँ कि जो सबसे बड़ी ताकत है वो ये है कि आपका फाउंडेशन बहुत स्ट्रांग बना देती है. उनकी पूरी कोशिश ये रहती है कि किसी तरह से पौधा जड़ पकड़ ले, क्योंकि एक मर्तबा पौधे ने जड़ पकड़ ली तो अंकुर तो फूटेगा ही.
आई डिडंट गो देयर टू लर्न अबाउट सिनेमा, आई वेंट देयर टू गेट द टप्पा ऑफ द फिल्म इंस्टीट्यूट एक्टिंग कोर्स. द एक्टिंग कोर्स आई पर्सनली फेल्ट वाज स्लाइटली फॉल्टी, गियर्ड टू मच टुवर्ड्स सप्लाइंग fodder to the industry in terms of producing villains, comedians, heroes, heroines.
I don't think so, because the kind of exercises we did were not meant for the film industry in Bombay particularly, but they were for any industry.
But the fact is, there was a great deal of worth in that course, and there was a great deal of worth in Mr. Taneja's presence.
3 months he taught us not to act. Come back from all that copying film actors and then dramatizing it and un sab ko bhul ke pehle apne aap ko pehchano, you be yourself, kora kagaz ki tarah apne aap ho jao, uske baad the characters will you behave like the character, you don't act like the character.
people also think of it as a career option. But when I went into the FTII, all of us who went in at that time used to go in because of a sort of undying love for cinema.
And I was like a real hungry sponge. I was just going all over the place, absorbing, and just complete acceptance.
Commercial cinema, what it today is, I learned from here. But I had the tools. That is the FTII which gave me how to use it. I knew what rhythm was, what pace was, you know, what a cut would be.
It's like a creative. I never thought that sound is creative in films.
And your ultimate goal is, you know, where you'll replay that sound in a theater, cinema hall. So you are prepared actually to know how it's going to behave down the line.
You see, I am a recordist who started working directly recording on optical film. Then I myself started magnetic recording, then to Nagra, and then to hard disk and Pro Tools and digital recording and all that. I would not have been able to pass through all these stages of improvement, all these stages, if I was not educated at Film and Television Institute.
So I was a completely novice, and as such also when I joined cinematography, I didn't know much about photography at that time, and even I have never taken a still photograph also, because I didn't have a still camera.
This is the growth. It would not have been possible if I was not there for 3 years.
Because it is the only probably film institute in the, well, not the only, but among the few film institutes in the world which has so much hardware in one place, which has so much access to all the equipment in one place.
For me, that's one of the most creative moments in my life, you know, doing those student exercises at the institute, because you were so raw, so naive, and full of exploration.
I would see a film in the evening, and the next day we would go and try it out, and then get it developed in the laboratory, see the results, see whether that is the style you like or not.
You used to learn whatever you wanted to learn, and rest of it you could just throw it out of the window, and it didn't make a difference.
FTII became like a red hot tube for me. Like two elements enter from this side, and this side becomes one compound. So that's what happened to me. I knew nothing of cinema, and I come out and I thought I know something about cinema.
As early as 1963, we had very well-known filmmakers like Ruthi Katak, great writers like Abbas, great actors like Balraj Sahni, and great film institutions like Mary Seton coming to the institute and lecturing there.
When I was in second year, Satish Ray had visited the place. He saw a few diploma films at the FTII, and in the evening when he spoke to the students, he said, well, I was always against the idea of film academics, because I never thought you can teach cinema to somebody. But after I've seen some of your diploma works, I'm very convinced that yes, cinema can be taught.
I studied every cut of Breathless on a movie online. I used to, you know, the camera moves up and he cuts and it keeps moving up, and I'm saying, why is this cut so brilliant, until I saw that little movement there.
Like once I was watching a film and I came out in my second year, and I asked my friend, how did you find the film? And he said, what do you mean? I was not watching the film. I just noticed exits and entries. And I said, my God, I missed it.
Point was, it was a place that allowed you to make mistakes, critically important, where you could make a mistake and learn from it.
Next film I watched only for exits and entries. But the filmmaking is not that, you know, it's not this. It comes from the spirit, then you realize.
Yes, to begin with, we were dazzled. Yes, to begin with, we were overwhelmed.
And yes, inspired.
The first film which influenced me was Megha Dhaka Tara.
So whatever I have learned cinema, bit of it, and I've used a bit of the cinema in my commercial cinema, is I would all credit goes to Ritwik Ghatak.
Secondly, world cinema ke jitne bhi bade filmmakers hain, unki tamam filmein wahan par hain. Jaise
Megha Dhaka Tara,
Uzu, Ajantrik, Seven Samurai,
La Strada.
Who was Federico Fellini? I had no idea.
That's where I saw Kieslowski for the first time, and
Vittorio De Sica's Bicycle Thieves.
And also Kurosawa's.
Let me be very frank that half the films I did not understand.
And when I was exposed particularly to European cinema, and especially the cinema of Ingmar Bergman,
it was a full toss for me.
I didn't anticipate that the accent would be so much on just these films. I had a complete neglect of the Indian cinema.
We were not so keen to know much about Indian cinema at that time, because everyone knew about it.
And when we came in, what was happening around the world? The French New Wave was splashing.
Yes, a Chabrol ki film, yeah, Godard ki film.
I did not know that such cinema exists.
And every day we used to see the films by Jansko, by all this from Poland, Hungary, Russia.
A variety of filmmakers, but all of them somewhere gave us something which makes us what we are today.
What Institute does at the end of 3 years is it puts you on par with any filmmaker in the world.
You know, it's the articulation part, it's the crystallization of thought, it's the basic fundamental understanding of concepts.
But when you come out with such a lot of confidence in you, such a lot of dreams, which you feel all you need is the money to reach, to be the best. Not the second best, but to be the best director in the world.
I mean, we are very confident. I mean, we were only waiting for a chance. That you give us a chance, I will show you.
That kind of a thing is it's a kick, and you have a power over it. Like, you know, you are better off.
And when I came out of the institute, I never worked with anybody. I just could take the camera and take the instructions from the producer, director, and start executing it.
Often what happens, we have already made a half an hour film and made a couple of other films, and we want to actually do our own thing, and we don't feel like assisting too much, you know, at that stage.
Somewhere there was the fear that maybe the Film Institute wasn't preparing you for the world out there.
Will I be accepted? Is it true that I'm not going to be able to get good roles? Maybe I'll only get the usual sister and supporting kind of roles.
There was a moments of fear, a moments of questioning.
You miss people, you miss the atmosphere, you miss all that you had studied, because when you come here, everything is different.
Ekta ka ek feeling hota hai na saath mein rehne ka, ek some kind of attachment sabke saath ho jata hai, even with the teachers and the staff, and also with the compound itself.
I tried to stay as late as possible. Even when I left, there was no one in the institute. I was the only one.
Second year jaise khatam hone ko aaya, jaise examination shuru ho gayi, from there only there was some kind of melancholiness or certain depression sort of thing sinks in, you know.
I cried the last day that I left. The previous night.
But I don't think we, any of us, entertained the thought of failure for too long.
I joined the film industry in the year 1971. At that time, these industry people used to look down upon the institute boys.
I wanted to enter into a studio to see a shooting, film shooting. The doorman stopped me. He says, "Who you are?" I said, "I'm an actor from Film Institute of India and I want to see shooting." He said, "Do you know somebody inside?" I said, "No." He says, "No, we don't recognize film school and we do not know what is Film Institute all about."
Boy, it was so tough. 6 years I didn't have any work.
And the other thing, I was a girl. So they said there's a girl editor, and you would come and peep, you know, people would actually open the dhak karke and peep in and look at me. And I was saying, am I a zoo animal or what?
People would be taking the meter reading, and if one of us would pass by, they will immediately cover it.
You know, it has happened with me many times.
Well, you know, they always made snide remarks that bhaiya, ye aapka institute nahi hai, yahan dusre type ki acting hoti hai.
In those days, people thought that it's a film institute graduates, they don't have any practical experience. They have got only theory knowledge. And that, and also they are all intellectual beings. And that sort of stigma was there.
They didn't know how to take us. They didn't know what was this. And definitely the defensive mechanisms were working.
That these new boys who have come and they have been properly trained will take over all the work and they will be left jobless. So they didn't hate us. They were afraid of us.
The initial ice in the industry was broken by these seniors, you know, who had come and established themselves already. They struggled a lot.
I passed out in 75 and by that time I think film industry people had started realizing the importance of FTII.
By the time we walked in, I think all the senior people had laid some ground for us that FTII, at least when it comes to behind the camera direction or editing or maybe cinematography or editing or recording, they are damn good people. They are good at their job. And one more thing, that they are very fast.
Film directors who were making films from ages, and when they worked with the technician from the Film Institute, their overall look towards the cinema changes. You know? They were only to zoom in and zoom out.
We've contributed greatly. We've contributed greatly in editing. Renu Saluja, I mean, is amongst the best in the world.
My dear friend Paddy of the sound recording course.
I never went asking for a job. Jobs came to me.
Aremu Mangalam Mahadevan Padmanabhan. I memorized his name under the wisdom tree.
There was a competition amongst the studios to hire FTII students, whether editors or sound recordists or even cameramen.
And in acting also, because I mean, look at the people we've had, Nasiruddin Shah, Puri, Jaya Bhadri, Danny Dinzongpa, Shatrughan Sinha, I mean, really.
But so far as directors are concerned, definitely there is something wrong somewhere.
When they want a good work to be done, they lap up the technicians from FTII. When it comes to the direction students from FTII, they always associate them with, you know, a set kind of filmmaking.
It doesn't mean that when you see felony, you can become a felony. It's I think one achieves that maturity in the institute. But it at least tries to discover the felony inside you.
Diploma went on to win the national award. My first professional film encounter with the faces was nominated for an Oscar, won the Golden Peacock.
And those who have done well have done so well. They have taken cinema forward so much.
Whether it is documentary film or whether it is mainstream feature film or whether it is the independent film or the regional film, you will find huge contribution being made by students of the FTII.
If you look at the, you know, national awards which is given out every year, at least 60 to 70% of the winners are from the Pune Film Institute.
Apart from Sajit Rai, probably all the filmmakers known to the West today are from the Film Institute.
What species that tree is something I'd like to find out. It's not a mango.
It's at a strategic point where it's open from four sides. So there are a lot of breeze.
Wisdom tree is a tree under which...
You fought a lot of battles sitting there under the wisdom tree. Professional, personal.
I was bullied and ragged and I used to run away from the wisdom tree.
Come down from the hostel and the first cup of tea and the wake-up call is actually under the wisdom tree.
You would stop there. You walking away or, I don't know, a wisdom tree cover, just stop there and sit down there.
Wahan baith ke kabhi ex-students aa jaate the, jaise Subhash Ghai was senior to us. He used to come there. Main bansri bajata tha.
I made a film called A Documentary on Death and most of that was conceived under the wisdom tree.
50% of my time at the FTII, I must have sat under the wisdom tree.
So many unhappy souls have sat there and felt better.
A lot of introspection.
Matters of grave importance.
A lot of fights.
And gaining a lot of peace. That tree has got a lot of vibes.
But I wouldn't mythify it, you know, thinking that if you sit under that tree, the wisdom automatically will get into your head. Though symbolically, yes.
I don't know whether we are wise or not, but if we are, we got it there.
It was wonderful. The wisdom tree is to me epitomizes all the joy that I received at the Film Institute.
When I made my first film, the first card which appears on the film, it says, "Thank you to Film and Television Institute of India."